over the last few years, as the world was going through financial turbulence, what seems to have happened here in Oman is that the ship has been wisely steered through those waters, and what you end up with today is an extremely efficient machine that ranks very highly regionally.
It is important to go out there, find out exactly what they know, what is their knowledge, and where they position you, with whom they think you are similar, and to find out how you can stand out against all these noises.
You might have an identity, but if you don't build on it, if it's not coherent, if it's not understood internally and externally, then you're not doing your homework.
We like to brag about our city, so I'm proud when Boeing sells an airplane overseas and I can say, that's my city. I'm proud when my football team wins a game, that's my city. It makes me proud. So I think we have to take that to the people we meet and constantly sell ourselves in our community.
Being an entrepreneur is sometimes a challenge. You think you're the only person facing these problems. So the value of things like mentoring, support structures, advice, and just bouncing ideas off each other become incredibly important.
It's okay to fail. If you fail once or twice, in the end, you need to fail to innovate.
So when we're talking about creating enterprise, where are we going with this? What are the challenges we're going to face? Who's going to be doing what, where, and when? And where are we going to be 5 years from now, 20 years from now?
Everything is local. In other words, the idea that whether it's STEM or economic development or enterprise, it has its own flavor, and that people need to recognize that their pursuits are what's important and that the opportunities stem out of that. So what works in Silicon Valley doesn't necessarily work in Oman.
The new economic imperative globally is the education and skills imperative. So this is something that really the upgrading of skills to the new era is something that every economy faces. And that applies to Oman as well.
Everything has to start young. And if you're training up young people, then when they leave school, those are ready-made people to be citizens that can contribute positively to Oman and how Oman then is seen to the rest of the world.
A community is going to be more competitive if at the heart of it, it can tap into its creative resources and its entrepreneurial spirit. And if you can change people's way of thinking, you can change their way of talking, you can change their actions, and that's where you get competitive action.
Sustainable development is all about meeting the needs of the present without compromising future generations. So there's a time element to this. It's not just about how we live now, but it's about what we're doing for future generations.
Social entrepreneurs are pioneers. We're taking new ideas, innovative ideas, and we're adding layers of environmental and sustainability to them.
Oman has all the building blocks, in my opinion, that any country needs to do renewable energy right.
We have to change that PlayStation into a shovel, you know, and let them know how to plant and how to grow and how to prepare, not just grow, how to prepare food and what it means to them. A lot of them just think, it's just something you stick in your mouth, you know. And I got tired of seeing kids eating from the 7-Elevens, the convenience stores, and some of them eat from the stores that's at the gas station. You know, some families, that's the meals they eat, and it shouldn't be like that. That's what I'm trying to change.
When we talk about smart communities, do we mean the technologies that are creating smart cities? Or do we mean the communities and the people? I think the general conclusion, which is agreed amongst everybody, is that it's actually the human capital that makes the real difference.
I hear the term smart communities. I really think about it rather holistically across different things, not just technologically. I don't imagine that every grandmother would need to use Twitter and Facebook to be on a community group's webpage, but to have empowerment and to have opportunities within community to fulfill one's potential.
The three messages, one are, do it and have fun. Secondly is, if you fail, just learn from the experience. And the third one is please, please celebrate success. I think the talents of young Omanis are absolutely superb.
But the general mood, I would say, is let's do it. Let's try it. The hurdle is not so high and the momentum is there. Just need to jump.
Everyone in the breakout session understood that this was something that they needed to do something about. So whether, and there was a father there with his daughter, there was a government minister there, you know, there were people from the Research Council. I think everybody recognized that they have a role to play and that this is no, you know, this issue belongs to everyone. It isn't simply a role for government.
We have all the ingredients to become competitive or to be competitive. We have it there. We have all the ingredients to be innovative. I want them to have that idea. Oman has this richness. It's just how to apply it, where to apply it, when to apply, how to use the skills. So it's all there. The infrastructure is there. But how do we work with it to enhance, to engage, to reach that level?